Hey, what's up guys, Jeremy here. Now that we have all the targets required to move the boxes around, it's time to create the subprogram to do so. Let's get started. Here's our station exactly as we left it. So we have our robot, tool, parts, and all the targets we need. So I can press minus a few times just to reduce the size of the targets a bit. And here under my part reference frame, I have all the blocks and I have all the targets. So before even getting started with the program to pick those boxes, I need to create my replace object program. This will be a lifesaver. If I do any mistakes, I'll be able to revert back to the original positions of all the objects. So I'm gonna create a program, call it replace objects. I'm gonna right click, add instruction, simulation event instruction. I will go for action, set object position relative. I'll select the first object, press shift, hold, select the last object. There's no more objects in there, and I'll click OK. So this way, if I move anything anywhere like that here, if I click replace object, everything will revert back to its original position. Always a good thing. Perfect. So now let's create the subprograms to pick the different boxes. So starting from here, you have two different approach to a program like this one. You can go for the everything in main approach, which I don't necessarily recommend, where you would have like one big main program where you would pick an object and then place it in the right spot and ping the other one, place it in the right spot and so on and so forth. And it will be like one single program. So that would work. And if you have simple stuff to do, that can make sense, but it wouldn't give you a lot of flexibility if you want to do stuff, let's say in another order, if you want to pick all the green boxes before picking the yellow boxes or something else, like if you want to simply have the dark one under the light one. So you wouldn't have as much flexibility. So what we'll do instead is we will create one subprogram per box we want to pick. So here, let's start by creating a program and let's call it F2 pick light yellow. So this will, in fact, be a program where I'm going to go and pick the light yellow box. So to do that, what I can do is simply select app pick light yellow, add a joint motion. I will then go down to the pick yellow, add a linear motion. If I scroll down here, you will see pick light yellow, set part, e pick, app light yellow, and pick light yellow. Now I can add a simulation event, attach object. I will keep the default setting for this one. It should work. And now I need to move back up to app light yellow using a linear motion. So if I test that out by double clicking on pick light yellow, sorry, or LY, going down, picking the object, moving back up. I want to reset everything, replace object, can test it out once more. So that's great. So now I can simply leverage the copy and paste functionality to copy and paste this subprogram multiple times to go ahead and pick all the other boxes. So that's gonna be a bit tedious. That's part of the game for this project. So I have six big programs or subprograms to do. In a later video, I will show you how to use one of our newest feature. So we have a palletizing feature that will help you do something like that in an easier way, I would say. But for now, we have to revert. So I want to show you how to walk before you run. So I'm not necessarily using all the most advanced feature all the time, because I need you to really understand the core of some of the features of RoboDK. So this will be pick light orange. So the next second one here. So this will be pick light green, and then we'll go and pick dark yellow, and then we will pick dark orange. I'm only going in the order like this one, this one, this one, this one, this one, and that one. So, and then the last one will be dark green. Perfect. So if I open pick light yellow, the only thing I need to change is right click here and select, instead of app light yellow, I need to pick light orange. So app light orange, and here pick light orange, and then here app light orange. So if I can test this one out, this one works. And we have to do the same for all the other subprograms. So pick light app light green, pick light green, and then app light green. We can test it out. It works. Replace object. Let's collapse this one here. Dark yellow. So we just need to go ahead, app dark yellow. And then here, pick dark yellow. And then here, app dark yellow. We can test it out. Collapse this one, replace object. You understand why I'm using the replace object all the time. I can test this and go back to your original situation pretty quickly. So we have dark orange. So app dark orange here, pick dark orange, and then app dark orange once again. Pick this one here, move upward, replace object, collapse this one. And then I will go and pick the dark green. So app dark green, right click here, pick dark green, right click here, and app dark green. Test this one up, works, it moves. Collapse this one, replace object. And we're done for this part of the project. So in the next video, I will show you how to create the drop programs and how to create the main program so that we have one single program that we can run in loop if we want. It will place all the objects in the right order and then replace everything back to its original position before starting the project once more. I hope it was helpful. In any case, have a great day, guys.